private protocol in device supervisor and data acquisition via USB. Today, we'll show you how to use USB to gather data and how to build and use the virtual drive demo Python app. This app can simulate and send private protocol data to device supervisor and also receive commands from device supervisor to change the data. Private protocol in device supervisor. Access and log in the gateway. Go to Edge Computing page. Enable Python engine and enable debug mode at first. Then the username and password of SSH should be displayed on this page. Enable fixed password and set the password as 129. Confirm the device supervisor is enabled and the version is newer than 2.2.1. Open the Python app folder via VS Code. Open sftp.json, which includes the configuration which accessing the gateway via SSH. Configure host as gateway's IP address, port call as SFTP, port as 222. Username as PYUser, password as debug password 129. And remote pass as this one, and you can copy and paste. Keep other options as default and save this file. Double-click and open the main.py. This file simulates the collection of private protocol data and realizes the functions of the data uploading logic, modifying the neurable logic and exception logic. This code defines topics for uploading data to device supervisor, modifying device supervisor data, and responding to the modified data. The format and interval for uploading data are defined here. The interval is set as 5 seconds. The data value of the upload data is simulated here. If we have modified the value via device supervisor, it will upload the modified data. Otherwise, it will upload the default data. And by default, this app will upload ABCD when the data type is string. Upload 100.0 when the data type is float or double. Upload 100 in other types. Open mqclient.py. This file builds communication with the local MQTT agent in the gateway. Open parseconfig.py. This file can handle the virtual controller and the virtual major point defined by the Python app's configuration file config.init. It can define virtual controller and virtual major points as required in the config.init. To define virtual controller in controllers, set the protocol as virtual controller and name should be at the same virtual controller's name in the device supervisor. Define virtual major points information in measures, including name that the controller belongs to and data type. We just use the default configuration file. Next, build Python application packets by SSH access to the gateway. Press Ctrl Shift and P to bring up the command panel, enter SFTP, open SSH in terminal, and press Enter button. Then VS Code will start to build the SSH connection to the gateway. Enter debug password 129 to build up the SSH connection. Right-click to the left and select Sign Local Remote. After the code synchronization is successful, enter the build Python app packet command and press Enter. After the build is successful, right-click and select Sign Remote to Local to download the built Python app packet. And the relevant Python app packet will be available in the built folder. Back to Edge Computing page in the gateway, and there's already virtual drive mode app in this app list. However, this app is created by the system automatically when signing Python app code and cannot run normally. So we need to import the Python app packet just built. Click the Add button, select Python app in the build folder and confirm. Then wait for the installation, the app. After installation success, enable the app and submit. After the Python app runs successfully, go to the DeviceSupervisor Major Monitor page to add the corresponding virtual controller named Virtual Controller, and add virtual major points under the related controller in which the name and data type should be the same in the configuration file. When configuration takes effect, the major point is online and the value is 100 as default. The value of the virtual major point can be modified on the web page as well. USB data collection. Next, let's see how to use USB port to collect data. After the serial device is connected to the USB port, you can see that the serial device type is FTDI by using the command. Collecting FTDI data requires the driver, and it depends on USB serial. So we should ensure the USB serial driver is loaded first. Use the command to check the loaded drivers of the gateway. You can see that the driver of USB serial has been loaded. If not, you can use this command to load it. On this gateway, I should just load the FTDI driver directly and execute the command. After execution, you can see the FTDI driver has been loaded. A device file named tty-usb30 will be generated in the dev directory. Execute the command to check the tty-usb device file in the dev directory, and we can see the tty-usb30 has been generated, through which we can collect the USB data. To uninstall the FTDI driver, use this command. After executing the command, we can see the generated device file has been deleted.
For more information, please visit inhandgo.com.